Team number seven.
So what we wanted to do was get the students involved, since they did decide on engineering as their academic career and hopefully their professional career, was to get them involved in technology and engineering right up front.
What we see is 12 of the finest designs in the hovercraft. Everybody is a winner in this.
Go, come on.
As basically we use microprocessors, wireless connections, iPads, which everybody's familiar with, and basically fans and rudders that they're gonna control with these microprocessors.
This whole main fan was an issue throughout the whole semester, but we finally got it to work.
Some of the students were extremely frustrated with this because where's the final answer? What is, you know, where is the look in the back of the chapter? Where is the answer? There is no final answer. In engineering, there isn't. It's an optimization.
My favorite part was programming. Since I'm an electrical engineer, like the bobot, we had a little robot, and you can see it'll probably one of them moving obstacles.
Nice!
Why a hovercraft? Actually, it teaches you a few things. One is mechanical motor control. I literally have to lift an object and levitate it off the ground. So in effect, what you're doing here is you're discovering what are lift forces. The first day of class, I think half the students, their hearts went in their throat. I think about half of them were ready to drop out and just said, this is way too much for me. But in the end, if you look at this, this is the penultimate engineering design. There you go.